last night movement by Sneha. Her husband, Ron, came home around midnight, and his wife was not there. She had a history of staying out late, so he went to bed. The police discovered that at 4 a.m. he received a phone call on his cell phone and checked his voicemail, although he claims he doesn't remember doing so. He awoke at 6:30 a.m. for work. Sneha had not contacted him or returned home. 3 minutes before the first plane hit in the 9/11 attacks, a woman resembling Sneha was seen on Sneha and Ron's apartment building security camera. She walked towards the elevator, paused, then exited the building. Because of the lighting, it was never confirmed to be her, although Ron swears it was his wife. Her family and investigators believe that after the attack, she must have gone to the site to help, since she had a medical background. She was listed as a victim of the terrorist attacks for 2 years before her name was removed from the list. The NYPD had found many details about Sneha's life that suggested she may have been elsewhere or already deceased when the towers fell. It was discovered that Sneha had recently been let go by the hospital due to repeated tardiness and alcohol-related issues. Shortly after, she went out to a bar with other employees. The outing led to her spending the night in jail. She claimed that a fellow intern groped her during that time. The prosecutor dropped the sexual abuse charge and instead charged Sneha with falsely reporting an incident. He offered to drop the charge if she withdrew the original complaint, but she refused and was held overnight. Sneha began spending nights out at gay and lesbian bars in the city, some known for their rough clientele. According to the police, she would sometimes leave with women she met at these bars. It was also found that Sneha's brother discovered her and his then-girlfriend having an affair, which her brother disputed. Sneha got another internship, but had already been suspended for similar problems. On the morning of September 10th, Sneha had been formally arraigned on her charge and pleaded not guilty. The police report says she and her husband Ron fought loudly at the courthouse afterwards about her problems and nights out. Sneha's family denies these accusations, and after appealing, they eventually got her name added back to the list of 9/11 victims. It's speculated that Sneha died in an unrelated